Hello, and welcome to the review of the open beta for the multiplayer medieval combat simulator, For Honor. This is Ubisoft's latest multiplayer series, and as you can see, we've got a lot of characters to pick from. Spear Lady, Big Japanese Swordman, Big Axeman, Sword and Board Viking Warrior, Tiny Lady with Twin Axes, basically an assassin with a short sword and a dagger, Conqueror with a flail and a big spiky shield, and a two-handed sword-wielding warden. I quite like the Orochi, who is a counter-attacking, dodging ninja. So, as you can see, these are our abilities. As you level up, you get to pick one of these, and as you gain experience within each level and within each match, you get to use those abilities as you go on. So, this game mode is elimination. The objective of the game mode is to take out all of the opposing team. You get one life, but you have the chance to be revived if you're not outright executed by your opponent. Each of us will start, each of the four players on our team will start facing one opposing character, and what will happen then is each of us is going to have to fight one opponent, and then if we win, we get to hopefully go and help one of our friends if they're still alive, or they get to go help one of their friends. It's a fun game mode, it offers a lot of tactical chances, and it encourages the one-on-one fighting design of the game that certain other modes don't. So, that's our opponent. Give us a salute to start the fight, and we get into the... There we go. So, what you can see is, we're going to keep swinging and swiping each other. I'm using a controller for this, so I'll be phrasing it in terms of that as we go. As you can see, I'm trying to dodge, get around, get the upper hand, and avoid his strikes. The triangle symbol within the body of my character there, which is what's on the left side of the screen, you can see it flashes white every so often. The white represents where I'm blocking and or swinging from. So, I am playing as an Orochi, and I'm trying to counter and parry my opponents as best I can. And you can see on my opponent, well, you could see when I was still alive, that anything he was attacking from, I could see where it was coming from. It would flash white on his body. The core concept of the game is that you counter your opponent by blocking in the right direction at the right time, and swinging in the right direction at the right time, and dodging. So, that round didn't go so well. It's quick sometimes. So, start again. This is the other knight, and we'll see what happens here. So, as we can see, he's taking a nice low approach. I've decided to move backwards, because I find that most of the knights tend to like charges. Like that one. So I take my swings, and I realize that I don't really want to fight this man. So, knock him back a little bit, and keep pushing until he's, well, off the map. It's nice to do stuff like that. Environmental kills are a part of the game. There's spikes, those fire traps you can see down there in the middle of the road. Those can be pushed into. The beam of light on my left, that's one of my allies. He has not been executed by an opponent killing him with a heavy strike. So he's going to go and get picked up by me, hopefully. Oh, no, apparently he's already been picked up. So the way the game works is now, because we have successfully defeated our opponents, and you can see at the top there that one of the opponents is straight dead, the others are standing in front of me now. The idea of the game is that we try and take all these guys out. He's going to run and hopefully try and get some health. He has not managed that. I managed to stab him. And by finishing my opponent with a heavy strike there, I could tap X or Y and execute them. So again, fighting away, we need to catch him. The blue markers you can see around his hand there, they are equivalent to the little sword, the floating blue sword you could see there just in front of him. They are power-ups, arcade style, and what they do is they'll boost your attack damage, boost your defense by giving you a shield, they'll regenerate your health, or they'll make you run incredibly fast, which is really useful in this moment of the game when, as you can see by the marker at the top, there are one blue character left and three orange characters. So I'm going to pick up this because I feel like I could probably use a hand finishing this guy off. So I try and knock him against and finish him off. So every character has two different executions they can equip to start with. That time I decided to cut his head off. It tends to work pretty well. Now, what you can see there was the really pretty maps that this game takes place in. It's glorious. So, now I'm going to use some of my feats. My opponent is a berserker. I don't like them very much. So I'm just going to shoot him and throw a kunai. Because they have a real problem where, as you'll see, they can get lots of hits in really quickly and just annoy people. So, simple solution. Slice their head off. So the gameplay is very fluid, very fast. You've got a lot going on in a very short amount of time. So I would liken this more to a fighting game than any kind of multiplayer combat game, like Chivalry. You're looking for parries and you're looking to get combos in. You're looking to break your opponent's guard by charging them. But you also have this tactical element of, oh, my teammate's down. If I can go rescue them, it means we're now back up to 2-on-3. Again, so the little bar that was filling up on the bottom right, or bottom left, sorry, they are basically gaining experience as we go. Now, I've picked a very poor fight because I hate fighting berserkers, because they just swing at you endlessly. And so I get executed. Again, it's even dying isn't that bad. If you die, if you get executed at the start of a round, it tends to have a problem where you end up waiting for a long time. But the beauty of this game is that, one, it is beautiful. I mean, the lighting effects alone are very pretty. But it's also just very fun to watch fights happen in this game. It has a really delightful aesthetic going on of fluidity and motion that is just delightful. So, here we go again. I'm going to set a trap, get out of the trap range, and ruin my opponent. And then just, you know, finish him off quickly. I think whenever this happened, he didn't really appreciate that. I think he took it in good graces, though. So, yeah, that's his chat icon down the bottom left. So, knowing that I've now beaten my opponent, I look up, I see that there are 2 dead on the enemy team, and I go to see if I can find my friends. And luckily, I didn't need to help there. I did, because I'm a good guy like that. But my opponent, the opponents were taken out. Now, one of the issues with this game is that while you can track your opponents using the minimap, the last person on a team does tend to have very little reason to do anything other than just run away and try and get resources and resurrect their team. So as you can see here, the Berserker, who, even though he has very low health, is now got fast feet and extra damage, and tried to resurrect his teammate, which would have put him on a reasonable chance of coming back. I've seen people hold off entire teams by blocking and fighting really well. So, seeing that he's running off and clearly outpacing us, he's gotten off and rescued one of his teammates. So now they're both trying to take out our opponents. So, finish him off with a kunai. There's no need to keep a fight going any longer than it should be. Now, occasionally, I find in the multiplayer sections of this game that people are either looking for a very honourable experience of one-on-one fighting. That didn't happen in this case. But you get a nice team shot here of all 4 of us appreciating what happened. So, that's the end of a match. I think we've got 2 in this video. So, end of a match, you get loot. You get an item which can boost your stats in a certain way and lower stats in a certain way. So that one, extra throw distance, or less throw distance, but I gain revenge meter by injuring people. This is the big war. I can't remember what it's called properly, but you deploy war assets in an attempt to sort of have a metagame going on. All 3 factions, the samurai, the knights, and the Vikings, are trying to take over territory. So this is the customization screen, different weapons, different gear, slightly different styles as well, which is neat because you get, there's only 9 characters, but there's a little bit of variation in each one, and some of them are actually quite pretty. The problem with this game is that it appears to function mostly on peer-to-peer networking, so there's constant disconnections. And it's a beta, I get that. So this is, I think this map doesn't end up going through because of another disconnection, but we do, I think I show off the combos here. So if we hit the menu button, you get to see a few more of the characters there. That's the Vanguard. So this is how the maps work. You get weather and location and time of day. So you can have a snowy map at night on the Viking River Fort or the cathedral in daytime but with fog, or the forest in mist in the morning. Now, I think... No, this is another disconnection. So we start the game and immediately crash. It's a little bit frustrating. But immediately get back in, join another session. So Cathedral, Elimination, Day, Ashfield. And then I think this game crashes as well. I'm not selling this well, but I mean the actual gameplay, fantastic. Just some servers would be nice. Just a couple of servers, just so we can connect them. So these are your move sets, your Renown, Revenge Mode, Defense, and basically these are the special characteristics for each character, and then your combos. So there are very little, there are few moves, but they can be combined in a reasonable way, and it works because the players have the ability to learn opposing move sets. There's not much going on, but there's a wide, there's accessibility there. So I think that game crashed almost immediately, so I just skipped the footage. And into the final game, I'm going to stick with Orochi because I appreciate countering and dodging, and I'm also not very good at fighting people while being slow. So straight in. Now this map has a couple of really cool things going on. Lots of traps. There's a pier down at the front of the map that you can pump people off into the water. I deeply, deeply adore doing that because it's by far the best part of the game. Now, I think part of what happened here is I was not entirely sure what was going on with this guy. He seemed to kind of decide he didn't want to fight me. And then I realized he was going for the upgrades so he could just kill me quicker. So, don't want that to happen. So, unfortunately, that backfired on him. Now, I've run out of stamina, which is why my screen has gone white, and I can no longer make swings or make combos. So, obviously, he panics because of what just happened. So I start chasing, realize he's going for the defense to get a shield, try and stop that. When you're contesting it, they can't capture, but you can still kill them. So I look around, see if I can find my teammates. I see that, oh, blue marker's down. Well done, salute, and off we go. See if I can find the final guy. And this is going to show why I really, really like watching this game. Because in the chat at the bottom left there, you see that, oh no, this guy has just spawned in on top of an AI. He hasn't taken any damage, but he now has to fight four of us at once. And, yeah, as the Berserker, you can activate your Berserker Rage in Revenge Mode quite easily, which do a lot of damage and stop you from being interrupted. So I try and draw him away here. He stuns me, which means I can no longer seam the markers to denote where attacks are coming from. And he ruins me, frankly. So the Viking swordsman decides to tank for a little bit, draws attention, and lets the peacekeeper get me back up. And all of us start fighting him at once. That guy held off three people reasonably well for a couple of seconds. If you can get one or two people fighting really well together, fights can go on for either an incredibly short time or a long time as they try and fight each other out and work out where your opponent's guard is weakest. We both salute. Some people salute quite and take the honor system very seriously. Others don't. They just charge you. So, start shuffling. One of my opponents is already down. He instantly breaks my guard and uses that to get strikes in. I break his guard, stagger him against a tree, and I completely misjudge the range. So I decide, best plan, get away from this. This is not a good plan. Get a defensive shield, get my armor back up, and start trying to pick him off. A little bit more confidence. And then I realize there's something behind me, which is bad. Don't check my minimap because I'm just panicking at this point. Want to catch up to him. And my opponent goes into revenge mode, which triggers faster when you're fighting more than one person. So, gets moving. I realize that he is still got that shield, and it's going to be a problem. So, pace him out and finish him off. Now, that ends up winning us the round. As you saw, I've gotten my second tier of upgrade. So I now have a kunai to throw. Kunai is quite useful for interrupting attacks, dodging, and taking off a chunk of health that you don't want an opponent to get. So throw it there, start the fight off nice and easy. And I'm not feeling confident about fighting this berserker because I saw him fight three people and win. And then his friend turns up and I just decide that that's not a fight worth winning because that will go poorly for me. I can't fight two people at once. I'm not that good. Run away. Panic, accidentally stab my teammate in the back. There is some amount of friendly fire, and it does take a little bit out of you. So, realize that everyone's fighting down here now. I should probably go help. Try and pick someone off at the back. Somehow I end up fighting the berserker again, and his berserker rage is just scary. So I run and try and get some health back. Now, this is a problem because I'm not watching the rest of my team while this is happening. So, get the shield. Get myself a temporary boost, just in case anyone's chasing me. Get the health benefit, try and get that built up again. And the red skulls you could see there, they mark opponents who are executed and cannot be revived. Or friendlies, sorry, cannot be revived, or opponents. So I misread the situation here. Turn around, and he gets his friend up. Just as my ally gets executed. So I begin striking, realize this is not a good situation. Run away. And I find myself in the same situation I was mocking earlier, where I can make the game go on for far longer than it needs to as I try and work out a position. The Vikings are very much built around doing damage and taking control. So when they pick you up like that, it's a little bit frustrating. So each of the classes have their own benefits. The Berserker is, as you can imagine, really fast and does damage quickly. The Viking Raider there with the big axe, he is designed to stop you from fighting. Same way I'm designed to counter. So the Orochi who took me out punches the ground in respect. I choose to believe that was in respect, and gets on with what the rest of his fight. So, round four. Now, I've been on this bridge before, and that man is designed to charge into me. So, do a little bit of damage, decide I don't want to fight you here because it will go poorly and you'll just throw me in the water and I won't be revivable. Run away, decide after the amount of times I fought this raider today, I should just, you know, get the boost, get the fight going, start chasing him, and then he recovers. So, get some attacks in. He keeps striking. And he keeps, he's got a good guard, but my stamina's down. And stuns me. So I'm in a very bad position right now where if he gets me with one good heavy attack, I am dead. But my benefit is almost back and he has 1 point to health. So a single kunai finishes the match and wins us the game. He was a little bit salty about that. So the game is fluid and fast and fun. Oh, it's so much fun, and it's pretty, and it would be really good to have the ability to play the game for more than two matches without it crashing. Back to the main menu. But yeah, For Honor is going to be a fun game, and I suspect that they're going to treat this like Rainbow Six Siege, where we're going to get upgrades and packs as we go on. So there's a lot to be looking forward to here. This is going to be... I feel it's going to be one of those games that ends up on Twitch near constantly, because this is just a very fun game to watch these ballet-like battles between opposing forces. So, thanks, and bye.